Award-winning playwright Sam Brooks is back with a new play, Burn Her. This is the second offering in Q Theatre's Matchbox 2018 season, and it boasts Miriam McDowell and Bree Peters as its lead cast. Bree and director Sam Sneddon join us right now. Welcome to you both.
Thank you.
So good to have you here.
Absolute pleasure. So it's a political drama. Who would like to tell us about it?
Sam.
Okay, so it's set on the night of the election, and a small political party has won a single seat in Parliament, and before the end of the night, an intern in the party comes to the party leader, who's played by Miriama, and says that someone else in the party has assaulted him, sexually assaulted him. And so then it's whatever, what she does and what Aria's comms advisor, who's played by Bree, George, what they do to kind of manage that situation is kind of, that's the meat of the play.
Okay, so women and power, mm-hmm. echoes of perhaps last election?
Actually, it was written before the last election. Mm. But, I think that one of the things that was quite interesting is when I first read it and heard it 2 years ago, is that every day that kind of went by, and particularly in the last election cycle, it just became more and more kind of apposite as a piece of work.
Mm. You know, it's interesting. I can almost see it as well as a TV show. You can always see it out there, and you get to play quite a cool-sounding character.
Yeah, yeah.
Is it about the role of the media as well, do you think?
I think it's about what perception, and sometimes it doesn't really matter what you believe or what you feel. It's how it looks, and that's a pretty grim synopsis. But sort of like, how do you work the system?
Perception is reality, essentially.
Yeah.
And in a time, I guess, where we're talking a lot about women in power, how does it feel to be involved with a play that was written well before the world started talking about this?
Oh, well, I mean, it just feels good in general. It's so good. It's so good to be a lead. It really is. I tell you what, the amount of times I've just been like, we call it an impact player, but it's supporting.
Right.
You know, you come on and you do your thing and then you come back and then you just play patience, you know, backstage for the whole afternoon. You know, like when I was little, I was the wise man 3 times, and I was never Mary. I was gold, frankincense, and myrrh. You know, I know every beard, and I just wanted to be like, well, why can't I want to be? And for this, it's like, it's amazing that, like, to be able to play with one of my best friends, Mitty, and on stage and be like, and just...
I think you're talking about me.
Oh, you, but yeah, as well.
I think that's without saying. So it's your time to shine. You play a ruthless spin doctor, George Rush.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about George.
Well, I mean, it's good because we've been playing her for a while. I don't see she's that ruthless. She's just sort of like, she sees the world differently to what Aria does, and Aria's very would you say optimistic?
Idealistic.
Idealistic. There you go.
Yeah.
And I'm a realist, and I just feel like I know the things you have to do, and the ways you've got to spin things, and the games you might have to play to win, to come out winning. And so that's sort of what George does, always coming out winning.
And Sam Brooks, he is the writer of this. Tell me a bit more about Sam, because you've actually worked with him, you're working with him.
A lot. So I'm directing 3 of Sam's plays this year. This is the middle one. So as far as I know, I'm directing the next one. I met Sam... Oh, God, it feels like a long time ago. I think it was about 6 years ago when I was running the Basement Theatre, which is a theatre in Auckland, and he was a young playwright, and I just remember being so struck about how complex his writing was, even in his very early work, and how he was able to get such interesting ideas across in such a witty and kind of, he's just such a good writer of dialogue, and the way of moving that dialogue, moving the themes of the play through that dialogue in a way that you don't feel like you're being battered over the head with them.
Because that's a real skill too, isn't it? To do that well.
It's so fun to say the words that he writes. He writes so well for women. Do you know, it's so amazing to be able to like be on stage and say the stuff that I've never ever been able to be naughty on stage. And I don't know, it's a lot to learn, but it's easy to learn because it's so well written, it just like comes out of you and you're like, oh my gosh, this is amazing.
So is it comedy? I mean, how do you explain it?
Yeah, good question.
I think parts of it are very, very funny. I think one of the things that Sam has created in George, that's Bree's character, is one of the great characters of New Zealand fiction, I reckon.
Is George likeable?
yes. I think I honestly believe there are going to be moments in this play where you're going to have people spontaneously applauding because she just calls it. And I think one of the things that's so great about that character is that she just goes, this is what it is. Mm. And I think it's so, we're just so lucky to have the cast that we've got, who are so brilliant. I mean, I've known Brie for a long time. We were at drama school together. So this is a...
Not that long ago.
It was ages ago.
I know, okay.
Oh, you left it this long to give her a lead.
Yeah,
oh, jeez.
No, I'm going to say, no.
And it's so, I said to her the other day, I'm so pleased that you're able to be in this part because Brie is a fabulous actress and it really is a part that meets her talent. So that's what I think.
And has anything changed? You know,
because it's true, babe.
You know, you think about Jacinda Ardern, you think mm-hmm. about Trump, you think about lots of different things that have gone on politically in the last couple of years as well. Mm. Has there been any adaptation to the play?
Yeah. I think Sam as a writer is... We only locked the script off, like, no more changes in this last week.
Wow, okay.
So it's been, he wrote it in 2016 and there have had to be a number of updates since then, just because the things that people have done have outstripped what the fiction were and the things that people have gotten away with or it seemed to have gotten away with. I think it's really great that we're doing this great piece of work at this moment where it is such the part of the zeitgeist.
There's more fire and as a woman, and I just know that me and Mim and Amelia, who's in well, and Andy, like there's a lot of fire in our bellies at the moment, especially as women and being women. It's like you get in there and you're like, it's such an amazing time to have, even just for this short time, a voice, a really big voice.
That's excellent.
And it's like, you know, who knows when that'll happen again, but at least you just... You know, have fun while you can.
But as I said, it's like it's not like you get battered with the themes of the play. Mm. It is such a good story, such a compelling story, and so well written that there's just enough of that stuff peeking through that it. But it is, oh God, it's such a good story.
Yeah.
I love the place.
You sell it really well. We have to go and see it. So, what do you want? The theatre goers. Front row. What do you want the theatre goers to get out of it?
Honestly, I want them to... there are moments that George has this incredible speech, which gets me every single time we rehearse it, and I just want people to jump out of their seats and applaud, because I think it is the...
It's no pressure, eh? Yeah, no. I better feel it. I've got it. Yeah, it is.
It is. No, but it is... There's a moment where George's character just kind of goes... She calls it. She says, this is the way the world is, and the fact that you can't see this is incredible. And it is such a kind of like a primal scream, but sort of beautifully written. It is, it's a wonderful, wonderful piece of writing.
A primal scream that's not in a tweet, which will be nice.
No, yeah. I know.
Amazing.
Hey, it sounds great. Thanks, guys, for speaking
awesome.
You.
Amazing.
Burn Her plays at Auckland's Q Theatre from Thursday until August the 18th. You can check out their website for ticket details.
What a fantastic collaboration of some very awesome people.